Because nerds rule. Geek tested, nerd approved.
Hey guys and gals, it is January 22nd of 2015. Put all of your Back to the Future jokes to the comments below and annoy everyone with your creativeness. Anyway, so I'm hoping this one works. I have tried to make videos this month. I've actually tried. It's just my computer. I think it was because there was a defective RAM stick. That's what I'm hoping. Every time I would open the editor, it just would not, it wouldn't work. It would get like halfway through a video and then just crash and make me want to kill something. So I took a RAM stick out, using half what it usually does, and it hasn't crashed yet, so we'll see what happens. It's time to open ourselves a nerd block. Now, I don't know too much about what is in this one. I believe there's a Doctor Who item, and I believe, I might as well keep my knife out, and I believe there's a Star Wars item. Whether or not that's a shirt, whether or not that is a bobblehead or a pop vinyl, that is my ultimate guess. There is a pop vinyl. It's either a pop vinyl, a t-shirt, or something that I probably won't use. And we'll just see what happens. So, got it all cut. Let's open it up. And the very first thing, well, I called it on this one, didn't I? Let me see what this looks like. I'm really iffy on if I would want shirts from this particular franchise, because quite frankly, the fandom isn't one that I'm very proud to be a part of. I'm just going to go ahead and say it. This one's not bad. This one's not bad. Okay, this one I could see myself wearing. At least it's not like a stupid mashup shirt. But we have the Doctor Who Sonic Screwdriver. Countless uses in time and space. So, not a bad shirt. One that I wouldn't mind wearing, which is always a nice thing. There's only been, I think the only shirt out of these that I haven't purposely worn yet was the Deadpool shirt. The Deadpool playing card. I think that's the only one where I was just kind of like, eh, whatever. The other ones have been okay. Oh, good God almighty. I did not expect this. I'm really utterly amazed at how far this thing has taken off. It's not just a typical meme. What? Oh, this is... This nerd block might be the one where I'm like, oh God, maybe I should reconsider. This particular meme has really taken off, and I don't necessarily understand why. Grumpy Cat. Grumpy Cat is literally everywhere these days. It's shocking. And this is the mix and match meme and plush Grumpy Cat. So I don't know if there's meant to be some kind of lanyard that goes with it. It shows a lanyard on the little thing here, but I don't know. Grumpy Cat in big old plastic nerd glasses that looks like they're not meant to be removable. It also, I don't know. I'm not going to try to. Some parts of it feel like it's stitched. Some parts feel like it's like a button. It's a Grumpy Cat plush. And not a very good one, because the whole thing with Grumpy Cat is the whole awkward mouth that it has. It's whole deformity. And the glasses for it actually, like, cover up its mouth, and the fur covers it up. You can't really see its little mouth. So it's really just this... that. Okay. This is the one. This is it. It's been, I think, about a year and a half of doing nerd blocks. This is the one that may actually break me. The next thing we have are scatterbrains. Seriously sticky deranged darts. Oh, good Lord. Stick them to almost anything. 3 darts and target included. I have never heard of these. They seem kind of like the whole, trash pack, guys? I don't know. Let's cut this open real quick. Let me see what this is. What is that? The Brain Bazooka. So, I don't understand. This is This is the one. This is it. I knew this day would come eventually. I guess we're going to tear that. So we have... Is this the target? Yes, it is. You can play darts with it. There's quite a variety of scatter braids you can get. Which ones did I get? Are they all the same? No, they're all different. Oh, goodness gracious. So... the first we have is a knight, because why not? Second is a cyclops. Yeah. The third might as well be a stereotypical nerd. The big glasses, the acne, a paper bag lunch that is just gushing, and they all have, they really weren't kidding. So I'm just gonna put that on there and put that on there, and then just, let's see that one. Oh no, too much oil on my skin, too much. So I don't, where can I put you? Will you fit on there? No, yeah, I've ruined that one. They do seem to stick anywhere, so that's good. It's nice that they have little caps so you don't ruin the stickiness of them. But I can tell the second one of these hits the floor, it's gonna be the same as every little sticky thing you get. It's gonna get all the fibers, all the hair, all the dust and whatever. And this one's starting to go, so I'm gonna just go ahead and take them off. And that whole sticky thing is going to be gone. I'm not... okay, that one's really actually on there. Ugh, there we go. That was kind of gross looking. Ooh, hello. Random hair curl. That's weird. There we go. I'm not going to try to throw these and stick them on the wall. Now that I've said that. Huh! There we go. I don't know if you can even really see, but it's stuck. It's stuck on the poster. So... it works. There we go. We'll see if they stay the whole video. Sticky brains. Nothing I would ever conceivably buy, and I'm assuming very, very cheap. So I'm going to have a hard time defeating this month's nerd block. Oh, Jesus. How are you supposed to even put these on? They don't even give directions. I'm gonna regret this. I'm going, if I can even get it on, I should have, ugh. If these are actually too small for, am I even doing the right ear? I don't know. If these are too small for my ears, oh, ow. Is it? Am I, oh God. Am I an elf yet? Am I a Vulcan yet? Am I other random? I want to die. Please, Nerdpuck, please redeem yourself in some manner. This is, see, I'm at the point now where I can't tell if I'm, there's one thing I see that may actually be really excited and it may make up for the whole thing, but I'm not sure if it's genuinely a good item that I'm looking at. Not this. This is questionable. Or if I'm just trying to redeem the block somehow. This isn't a bad little bookmark. From the Noble Collection. I've heard of the Noble Collection, so that's not a bad little lenticular bookmark. I actually still prefer using books to an ebook in some regard, so that's not bad. And it also gives you a pen that is in the shape of, I'm assuming, Gandalf's staff. So, little pen that may get used, may not. Got little carvings in it. I don't know. Kind of hurt my spirits, nerd buck. Oh. I'm assuming this was NerdBlock's idea to have a cute little item that incorporates all of this month's items. So you have a Star Wars item that I haven't gotten to yet. The Star Wars item is interesting, if it is genuine. There's a Doctor Who TARDIS on here. You have the Enterprise from Star Trek, X-Wings, Millennium Falcon, Grumpy Cat, because I didn't mention it. And it's a dartboard meant for your sticky brains that, yes, are still sticking on the wall. So that's not bad. As far as things that I've thrown that have stuck on the wall, they're actually sticking longer than anything else. So that is one positive thing I can say about those, that the material, whatever it is genuinely sticky. But we have the Office Decision Maker, which has fine subjects such as take a break, do it today, pretend to work, take tomorrow off, go on Facebook, Google something, work ahead, organize work area, learn something new, throw dart again, yes, no, maybe, watch YouTube tomorrow. And then, of course, just a blank dartboard. They tried. But, that's cool. So, the one redeeming item in this whole thing, there are two things left in the box. The one redeeming item is a film self from Star Wars The Empire Strikes Back, Episode 5. And it does look like a genuine film cell. It doesn't appear to be a reproduction. I'm going to try to open this up so I can show it somewhat better. Let's go ahead and take that. Let's go ahead and squeeze you out of there. And it even comes with a little certificate of authenticity from Premier Cell. The certificate of authenticity guarantees this Premier Cell collectible is a genuine official product from Trendsetters LTD Limited. Each collectible is hand-assembled and contains one scene from the movie captured on authentic 35mm scope film. So, this little business card that I could have printed will tell me that's real. So let's see, if I hold that up there, and if I put, no, that's not, hang on, okay. I got this, quit telling me what to do. Close that, open that. There we go. So there's... this is the worst idea I've ever had. It is a film cell from Empire Strikes Back. And it looks like it is on Hoth. I can make out that much. If I have something... Ooh, wait, hang on. Nope, that's not really going to work. But you can maybe see it. It is from Hoth. So... that's a cool little item. Definitely the best thing in the entire Nerd Block for this month. And admittedly, that's not really saying much. How long have I been recording? 14 minutes. Okay, that's not bad. I don't know why they didn't stick this inside there with it, because this is literally in the bottom of the box underneath the last item. So stick that in there. There's my little film cell. So, best item in there. And the very, very last thing in here. From IDW and Boom Studios, Star Trek, Planet of the Apes, The Primate Directive. Issue one of I don't know how many. So clearly at some point we decided it was a good idea to have the classic series of Star Trek. I hope I said Star Trek and not Star Wars. Crossing over with the Planet of the Apes. Not the first thing I would have thought of for a crossover comic, but at least they are two sci-fi type things, and it's not a random. So is that really just a cardboard stuck inside to keep it preserved? Yes, it is. Okay, well. Comic book. You or me on the back. And I have blonde hair, so it's not quite me. Keep coming by garbage. Oh, because it's Garbage Pail Kids. I thought that was like their little self-referential joke that, hey, you have a box of garbage. Yeah, the artwork looks good. Try to find one that's actually worth showing off. Bridge stuff, bridge stuff. Do we actually have the apes and the Enterprise crew interacting in this issue? Oh, one of them fell. Behind the bed forever. It's no longer sticky. And that's the phone. That's cool. While the phone rang, the second of the darts fell off. I've been flipping through the comic, waiting for the phone to stop ringing. This doesn't look exciting at all. Now, granted, I'm not reading the plot. I'm just basing it off pictures. But in this whole issue, there is no interaction between the apes and the Enterprise crew. None. There's a quick part at the beginning that shows apes. Then it's all Enterprise crew. And then the very last page, Kirk and Spock see one of the apes. And then the teaser for the next issue is... oh, God. It's been so long since I've seen Planet of the Apes. Charlton Heston's character. It's gone. Sorry. Meeting up with Kirk at that famous scene. And... also, apparently, we have a little preview of other things that are available. It looks like at some point an Edward Scissorhands comic started up. So that's something I've always wanted, Edward Scissorhands in comic form. Well, the card. Here's what's inside. Grumpy Cat just wants to be left alone in a different universe, away from all of you. But unfortunately for her, she is in this month's Nerdblock instead. That one would have been a whole lot better to get because you can actually see the grumpy mouth of Grumpy Cat. The Hobbit pen and bookmark. Apparently, I could have gotten a Bilbo bookmark with Sting. And personally, I think Sting as a pen would be a whole lot more exciting. So if I had gotten that, I would have felt a whole lot better. This isn't bad as it is, but it's not really all that exciting. Right like you went to there and back again. Or to there and back. Apparently I can't read today. With his replica Sting pen. Yeah, mine's not Sting. Oh no, my camera is saying the battery pack needs to be checked. I gotta wrap this up. Elf Ears, Planet of the Apes, Star Trek Comics, Scatterbrains, and then the film cell. Which apparently they are all from Empire Strikes Back, of all things. So yeah, not a fantastic nerd block. Definitely, I don't know if it's the worst I've gotten, but it's definitely one of the worst. The one redeeming thing was the film cell. Everything else is just, as I was saying, of course, this is probably the worst unboxing I've done because the camera battery died way early. So yeah, the Grubby Cat thing, the elf ears is comically bad. This is probably the worst thing that they have included in these boxes, are the elf ears. Those are, no. The Hobbit bookmark and the pen are probably the second best item in this particular box. Would have loved to have Sting, because that could possibly be a letter opener too, maybe. Gandalf's staff is just, it's not that exciting in terms of a pen that you could have. So that's, the Scatterbrains did fall off. I don't know if I mentioned that before. Okay, not terrible. The sticky material is rather interesting, so that's something. And I find it very funny that there's a list of rares. There's common, uncommon, and a common, rare, and then ultra rare. So there's that. I think that's it for this one. And the shirt. The shirt itself, not the best shirt, but definitely not the worst shirt. So I'm not even going to try to defend this month's Nerd Block. Usually I'll try to defend it in comments and say, yeah, it's not too bad. It's, you get some good things, some bad things. This is definitely one of those where it's like, oh, that's, yeah, this is a box of crap. Not literally, thankfully. So yeah, we'll see what happens next month. They have said that there's going to be an exclusive item that you cannot get anywhere but Nerd Block for Better Call Saul, the Breaking Bad spinoff. I'm excited for that. Hopefully it's something good and not just like a pop vinyl that has a little thing that's, I don't know. I have no idea. But that's all I know for next month. If you do want to sign up for Nerd Block, there's a link in the description down below. Don't let this one sour your whole opinion. Watch some previous unboxings. I've had some really good ones. I've had some that were just kind of eh. This is definitely one of the not so great ones. But there's a link in the description down below. You can get Arcade Block, which is all video game stuff. You can get the Nerd Block Jr., which doesn't have a shirt. You can get the Nerd Block. You can get the Horror Block. I also say the Nerd Block Horror. The Horror Block. It's horror. And I think that's all of them. I don't know. We'll see. This one definitely didn't do it for me, and I'm kind of left me with kind of a letdown feeling. But that's the gamble. That's the whole gamble with these monthly subscription boxes. You may get a good thing, you may get a bad thing. So I'm not too broken about it. There is always that risk that you will have one that you don't really love, and maybe some people will like it, maybe some won't. Oh, and of course there was the Star Trek Planet of the Apes comic book, which looks like doesn't get exciting until issue 2. So it's great to give you issue 1. See, I'm trying to justify it. I'm trying so hard. It's good they gave you issue 1 so you can see how the story starts. That's nice. But yeah, not a great one, and I'll probably give this to my cats. I'll probably let them play with this. Maybe I'll like shove catnip up its butt and just tell them to go crazy with it. I don't know. But anyway, guys, I thank you for watching this. I hope I can get this thing uploaded. And if this does work, then I can actually get reviews done, which I'm excited for, because I thought my computer was actually broken. That was sad. But I will see you around. Thanks for watching, as always. Probably my longest Nerd Block I've done. And I'll see you around. Take care.